Welcome back. Here I have a partial map of gene regulatory network of mouse brain. It is partial because it shows only 63 genes. A complete network will have thousands of genes. Now suppose you want to study the dynamical properties of this network. But that would be a daunting task, both experimentally and mathematically. What if we can simplify a big network? That is where we borrow from engineering. Here is an electronic circuit. Though looks complicated, it is made up of few components: resistor, capacitor, diodes, etc. If you zoom in, you can break it down in few smaller circuits like amplifier, rectifier, filters. Each of these circuits have unique input-output behavior. Here I have an integrated circuit. It is made up of just two components, a resistor and a capacitor. It converts a square wave into a triangular waveform. Similarly, biological networks are also made up of smaller subnetworks that are repeatedly used. We call them network motifs. Network motifs were first described for gene regulatory networks. Large gene regulatory networks contain a small set of recurring regulation patterns or motifs. Each of these motifs has certain input-output behaviors. Take this motif. X activates Y, Y activates Z, and Z inhibits X. So, this is a negative feedback. A negative feedback can generate a transient response. It can generate oscillation and it can reduce cell-to-cell variability in gene expression. Similar network motifs are present in other networks like a cell signaling network, metabolic network. We will learn the dynamical behavior of some common network motifs. If we know their input-output behavior, we hope that we can stitch them together to understand the dynamics of a large network. Before we proceed, let me remind you that a network motif is not defined by molecular details. We do not bother about the genes, the enzymes that are there. We are only concerned about the structure or topology of the motif. In other words, we are concerned of who controls whom and how. That's all. Further, we describe these motifs in terms of 1, 2, or 3 molecules. However, in reality, a particular motif could have more than 3 molecules. Even then, we club multiple molecules together to create a reduced model. For example, consider this circuit. It is a negative feedback. It has 5 molecules. But as A, B, C, and D are linearly connected, we remove B and join A directly to C. Similarly, I remove E. That creates an equivalent 3-molecule motif. It is a reduced model, but still a negative feedback. Finally, remember that the dynamics of a system depends upon the parameter values. Even though we want to generalize the input-output behavior of a motif, such generalization is true only with certain constraints of parameters. For example, a negative feedback will trigger oscillation only for certain parameter values. For other parameter values, it will lead to a steady state. So we have to be very careful about the generalization. That's all for this video. Let's explore some network motifs.